determine in your heart that it's irrelevant. At least are totally not even, you know, supposed to come up, because we need to give God all the best. I want us to just start by surrendering our hearts to God this morning. Give your heart to God. Lift up your voice and tell Him you want to submit yourself to His use in worship this morning. You want Him to teach you how to worship Him in the right way.
Holy, holy, you are. imagine, praise God, just imagine the giving for God. I just put it in that song. I say, I call him Jaira. Lord, you are Jaira. You have been Jaira to me. I call you Jaira. You have been Jaira. Jaira you are. I am Jaira you be. Now is that time to pray.
Thank you.
worshiper in this house. Wave your hands and worship God right now.
You are beautiful. You are beautiful.
Turn it back a minute. Come on, sing.
Hosanna,
sing.
You are awesome in these days, I love.
Sing it, mean it.
You are awesome in these days, I love.
We reverence your awesome presence. Sing it.
Thank you.
appreciate God. Our God is faithful. Our God is awesome. That road that you tread upon every day, so many are treading upon that road, and they are no more. But here you are, in the presence of the Almighty. You are in the sanctuary and not in the mortuary. Appreciate Him. Give Him praise. Our God is good. That song says He is beautiful.
Package your offering while if you have packaged your offering, stand up to your feet, lift up your offering to the Lord, begin to speak unto that offering. Once upon a time there were two brothers who went to offer unto the Lord, but the Bible made me to understand that unto that of one he had respect and unto the other he did not have respect. I don't know what Cain did that the Lord did not have respect. Maybe his heart was not right. Maybe the offering was not good enough. But this morning, as you lift up that offering unto the Lord, ask the Lord to have respect unto you, to accept you, and that he accept of offering. and that as that seed fall into the ground, that it will return with a harvest unto you. That that seed will connect you to your promises, the covenant of glory of October 2014. That the beauty of the Lord overshadow every ugly situation in your life, and that every test surrounding you and your family will become a testimony from now henceforth, that this offering from today onward will speak for you. So shall it be, in Jesus' name. The choir, please. Yes. Accept us and accept our offering in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Please, you may have your seat. Yeah. Are there titles in the house?
Yes.
If you're entitled, stand up on your feet.
Grace.
should just be on their feet. You are just pay your faith and your tithe. Just be on your feet. Let us pray. Our God and our Father, we thank you because you are a faithful God. It's a command. It is not as convenient that we should bring all the tithe into the storehouse. Your children, that they have brought their tithe, things will not be tight for them.
Amen.
Cause the windows of heaven to be open over their lives,
Amen.
Over their finance,
Amen.
Over their health,
Amen.
Over their children,
Amen.
And over everything that pertains unto them.
Amen.
Pour down blessings,
Amen.
And bless them,
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
On the account of this tithe, send help from sanctuary unto
Amen.
Them. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord now.
Hallelujah.
It's almost sounding very cold this morning. You know, this God has done so many wonderful things for us. He's ever present. He's ever ready. He's the one that watches over us at every opportunity. Now just think about it. What if God goes on vacation? Huh? So if you don't want this God to go on vacation, I want you to rise up and give him praise. Say something wonderful to this God. He's the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. He is the I am that I am. He is the bright and morning star. He is the beginning and he is the ending. Father, we magnify you.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have praise.
Amen.
You can have your seat. Now, there are some people here. If you are here this today and you want to testify of the goodness of the Lord, God has done something wonderful, miraculous, joyful in your life, and you want to share the testimony to the glory of the Lord and to edify the congregation, I want you to wave your hand. Praise the Lord. One person there, another person there. Could you please step forward? We'll take those two very quickly.
Yes,
because today is Jericho praise. So three. Praise the Lord. We want to make it sharp and short. So please don't let us have to take the mic from you. We don't want to do that, as you very well know. So please, let's do it very snappy and let the people know what God has done for you. As we say, once I was blind, now I can see. All glory to God. So who is first?
Okay. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
First of all, I want to thank God for my life. I want to thank God for my family. I want to thank God for God's faithfulness. Faithfulness. He's been so faithful to me. I want to give him praise especially because during summer, August, okay, before I traveled, I was down to nothing. Okay, I run my own business, first of all. So I cargoed like twice in July and then it was stuck. We're having narco crisis in Lagos. It was stuck for over a month. And then I was going to travel the next month to do some business as well. And then I was down to nothing. My money got stuck. Customers were angry. They were complaining. And then I told God that this is your business. I started this thing with you that you should take control and everything. So in August, I was set to travel. And then I didn't have money for anything. And then I was talking to my mom. I was like, Mommy, if I book this ticket, what will I use to buy things when I get there? And then my mom gave me a word. She was like, within 10 days, don't worry, that God will give you 1,000-fold. And I just really want to bless God because indeed, God did it. I traveled, I booked my ticket, and then after I booked my ticket, my account was down to zero. But I traveled with faith, and I want to really bless God because as I traveled, the goods got released before I left, and then money came in, and then everything just went back to normal. I really want to give God praise for that. Praise God. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. In fact, I don't know that for someone to be sleeping is a great joy. Until last month, I just discovered that for almost 2 weeks, I could not sleep. When I call my mom at home, they say I should visit the doctor. I visit the doctor, they check my blood pressure, everything is okay. And the doctor needs to refer me to another doctor. I say, because of what? Just want to sleep. And the last two Friday that all the medical team came here, they check everything, that everything's okay. I don't have malaria, parasites, I don't have anything. I said, what is happening? So I started prayer because of I cannot sleep. I just thank God. May everything just come back to normal. For complete 2 weeks, I could not sleep. Just sleep for 30 minutes. If I've decided to cover my face with everything just to sleep, nothing. I just give glory to God for this grace. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. September in my life was, I don't know, it's actually a tragic month. 1st of September, one of my sisters was around in Dubai. So 1st of September, she asked us to take her child to the salon to make her hair. So we went to the salon. The second day was her child's birthday. So we went to the salon, they finished her hair and tried putting the tip in hot water. They poured water on the girl's back, hot water. So we rushed her to the hospital. The first layer of the skin peeled off. But I thank God the girl is fine and everything is back to normal now. And on the same day, as I was going home later at night, after I left the hospital, I got home and I came down from the taxi, and unfortunately for me, I closed the taxi door on my child's finger. So I rushed him back to the hospital again. I was crying, and the hand was bleeding, the finger was bleeding. And I was crying, I was like, what kind of day is this? September 1st of all days. There was so much stress. So afterwards, again, like a few days after, I was cutting watermelon in the kitchen. And then I cut my hand, you can see. And they had to stitch it in the hospital. That was another thing. So I want to give God the glory. And just like a few days ago also, my child has diarrhea and he was vomiting at the same time. So I got to the hospital, they told me he's dehydrated, so they had to put him on drip. So I thank God for that as well. He's okay and he's here with me. Praise the Lord. And I also want to thank God for my husband. He traveled, and I want to thank God for a safe flight. And I want to thank God for everything in general. And today is also my wedding anniversary. Thank you. Thank you, Lord.
Praise God. I want to thank God for saving my daughter Peculiar yesterday when I was here in the choir practice. As I went home, Princess was telling me, and Mommy, Peculiar went out of the balcony and was standing on top of that pavement, and she was with a cup drinking juice. So it was the cup I fell, not my daughter. Praise God.
Come on, give him praise. Clap your hands for this God. He's a wonderful God. He's the one that gives us a thousand fold blessings. He's the one that heals. He's the one that saves us from that evil spirit that wants to take the blood. I want you to stretch your hands to these ones and declare something good unto them. Pray that their testimony this morning will be permanent. Ask God to seal it with his yea and amen. Ask God that their testimony will be everlasting, that the healing that they have received will be whole, that nothing evil will befall these ones as a reason of this testimony, that their life will be an example unto many. And not only will it be an example unto many, it will be a blessing to generations. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Amen. Precious Father, we thank you for your children. Daddy, we thank you for the miracles that you have performed in their lives. King of glory, we are asking and we are praying that everything that you have done, you will do it permanently. Amen. King of glory, you will shield these ones from the eye of the evil one. Amen. Nothing will befall them because of this testimony. Amen. Father, they will move forward and never backwards. Amen. Their life will be a shining example unto many. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Put your hands together for Jesus as these victorious ones go to their seats. It will be your turn in Jesus' mighty name. Talk to somebody and say, it will be your turn in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. So now we are going to listen to Gap News. And immediately after that, our mistress, the Grace Assembly Special, will come forward and usher in the word of God. God bless you as you listen in Jesus' mighty name.
concluding the month of fruitfulness. We are already swimming in the river of joy, health, forgiveness, promotion, prosperity, and many more. And we're rightly positioned for a new season, the month of October, where we're entering a new covenant with the King of Glory himself. Welcome to Jericho Praise Service. It is with great pleasure to present to you another wonderful edition of Gap News and Amazing Grace Network. I'm Stephanie Isabelle.
And I am Okiki Bankole.
A very special welcome to those worshiping with us for the first time. This is Grace Assembly, a parish of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. We're glad to have you in our midst. We love you, and we pray that the Lord visits you in a very special way today. Kindly stay behind in the front row to my left for a brief reception with our ministers and our welcome team. Also take note that there will be light refreshments served to my left as you make your way through the exit doors of the church auditorium. Thank you. Kindly take note of our regular services. Our family service holds here every Friday, starting with our workers' meeting at 10 a.m. and our Friday school at 10:30 a.m. Daily news services, which is our Bible study, holds here in the church auditorium every Monday at 7 p.m. House worship meetings hold every Sunday or Wednesday at 7 p.m. Please look at the Jewel, our weekly bulletin, for the center closest to you. God bless you as you attend. Thank you. Workers in training, believers, and baptismal classes continue today at the end of the service. Participants should please be seated at the usual columns 15 minutes after the service. Thank you. Sinspiration, sinspiration, sinspiration. The Amazing Grace Choir of this church will be celebrating the choir weekend with a life-changing worship concert. Themed Mystery of Worship. This will hold on Friday, the 17th of October at 6 p.m. with Nathaniel Bassi as guest minister. The concert will also feature Funke Akioko Ministries and all the RCCG choirs, drama, and comedy. Please save the date. The youth and singles of this church will be having an event on the 11th of October. This will feature games and sporting activities such as football, table tennis, basketball, and it promises to be loads of fun. The theme for this event is Walking with God, and the venue is our Pastor Park 2. A professional instructor will be present, and light refreshment will be served. Please endeavor to attend. Grace Assembly would like to say a big thank you to the pastorate, welfare, the health professionals, and the youth and singles team for the successful hosting of the health fair. It is believed that we were greatly blessed. To this end, there will be a brief meeting of the welfare, health professionals, youth and singles team immediately after the service today. The Lord bless you all as you attend. All ESCO members of the Kingdom Partners should please note that there will be an emergency meeting today immediately after the service in order to discuss matters arising. May we remain steadfast and walk on the Kingdom Path in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Are you interested in joining the media department to serve the Lord with your talent? Please see the media HOD after the service today. All media team members are reminded of their meeting, which holds next week, Friday, the 10th of October. This will take place at the Children's Church immediately after the service. Please note this date in your calendar. The Redeemed Christian Church of the Holy Ghost service will open tonight at 10 p.m. Please remember to watch live at www.rccg.org. The theme for this month is Overflowing Greatness. May our cup overflow in the name of Jesus. Amen. We would like to remind the church, the CDs of our various services are available outside the church on sale. You may also want to book our past messages and listen to again. Grab a copy and be blessed. Thank you. Please be reminded that the prayer cards are available. Remember to pick a copy from the ushers, fill and drop in the box at the main entrance. Thank you. We would like to wish our very own pastor and mommy Olasuju a happy wedding anniversary. Happy wedding anniversary to our family. We would like to celebrate with you your special day's anniversary. Based on this, we have made provision for a slip to fill in the jewel. Please fill and drop with the ushers. May God bless you as you do so in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Please stay updated on all church events and activities by our church website, Twitter, and Facebook page. Should you have any question, comments, or feedback, please contact the Grace Assembly team on media@rccggraceassemblydubai.org. Thank you. There is a vacuum in man that can only be filled by his creator. Man is a relationship being that yearns for relationships everywhere. To enter a new covenant, to live a new life, to do a new thing, get into a relationship with God through his son Jesus Christ. Receive his salvation today because it is free. With his salvation, you fill all vacuums in your life and you're empowered to stand upright. That's all we have for today. Thank you for joining us. See you next week. I remain Okiki Bankole.
And I am Stephanie Zibo.
The Lord. Praise the Lord, church. If truly you don't know, all those hands, please can you just stand in square of the Lord? You can do better. And the man of God told us that he was being showed a revelation. And he noticed the angels that are attending to prayer in heaven. They are so busy because people keep bombarding God with prayer requests. But the angels that are in charge of praises, they are just idle. This morning, I want us to join the choir to sing these songs together. If you don't even know the song, just do everything. Let God himself know, truly. You know the words of him keeping you alive to this moment. The choir is here to present a song to you. Let there be praise in the house of the Lord.
Holy Spirit, we are going.
Let it be praise in the house.
for praise. There is a friend and a man of God in the house that will exalt us for about 20 minutes. Amen.
Amen.
Because there's going to be a praise in the house today.
Amen.
And ushers, please, you can remove all this seat, because last month, with these seats, we just need to remove them. So we have just only short time for the word. Amen. And he's a pastor from Nigeria, Redeemed Christian Church of God, and he's here in Dubai, and he's a friend for the short period that we have met. So he's going to exhort us for the next 20 minutes. Amen. And as just join me as I wake up Pastor Johnson from Olawunni to the podium. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you happy to be in the church this morning?
Yes.
I can hear you. Are you excited to be in God's presence?
Yes.
If you are excited, can you shout a bit, hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Bless you. You may be seated. Firstly, I want to appreciate the Most High God for the privilege given to me this morning to be a blessing. And I want to appreciate the pastorate, especially the pastor in charge of this great church, Pastor Sunday. Thank you very much, sir. And I want to appreciate Pastor Folabi also. God bless you. The entire workforce, you are wonderful people. The Lord will bless you.
Amen.
And I want to appreciate every man and woman seated here this morning. You are here to praise Him and to dance. You have not come to see any man, but to see God. And I believe, God, that after this morning, your life will not remain the same again.
Amen.
You can do better. Your life will not remain the same again.
Amen.
In the precious name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Once again, I bring greetings all the way from Nigeria, the Redeemed Christian Church of God, the Sheep Shepherd's Church, Lagos, Nigeria. I believe, God, the little time we are going to spend together, by His grace, your life will not remain the same.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The theme for this month is the covenant of glory. And I'd like you to just pay attention. I have a very limited time, and I believe God of heaven will speak to you.
Amen.
Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
For this great month of October.
Thank you.
We thank you for January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September. We thank you for this great month of October. We thank you for all that you have done. Thank you for what you have started doing already this month. Thank you for what you will do this morning. Lord, I ask that your name be glorified.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. As we look at the Lord, Prophet of Liberty, Lord, I pray that you will make your word real to your people.
Amen.
That we have an encounter with you this morning.
Amen.
Father, we give you the praise, Lord.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I want to reemphasize the theme for the month, Covenant of Glory. And I'd like you to just follow me, you know, very briefly. Take my reading from Psalm chapter number 89. Read verse 34 quickly. My covenant will I not break, nor alter the things that is gone out of my lips. My covenant will I not break, nor alter the things that is gone out of my lips. Psalm chapter number 84, quickly I read verse 11. Psalm chapter number 44, 84, I beg your pardon, verse 11. For the Lord God is a sun. Another version says, the Lord God is a light and shield. The Lord will give grace. Can I hear amen to that?
Amen.
And glory.
Amen.
Noble things will he withhold from them that walk uprightly. I'd like you to take note of these two scriptures. Powerful. And I want to take you on a journey of glory this morning under the leadership of the Holy Spirit. And if you care to follow me, which I know you will follow me, it is my prayer that we'll get there.
Amen.
Can I hear a better amen?
Amen.
The journey, please take note, the journey of glory begins with revelation. Let's somebody say revelation.
Revelation.
Say it one more time, revelation.
Revelation.
The journey of glory begins with revelation. Jeremiah chapter number 1 verse 11. And the Lord said unto Jeremiah, Jeremiah, what seest thou? And what was his reply? Jeremiah said, I see a rod of an almond tree. One thing is to hear that this month is the month of covenant glory, declared by God's servant. Another thing is for you to see it. What you see, you can forget easily. I mean, what you hear, you can forget easily. But what you see, cannot. What you hear, you can forget it easily. But what you see is difficult for that picture to go from you. The journey of glory is the journey with revelation. Many people look, but few people see. If you don't see anything, you will accept everything. And that's the truth. If you can't see anything about life, you will accept everything. And it takes inside light for you to see outside right. It takes inside light to see well, to see outside, because there are a lot of things that will be contending with you to distract your destiny and your attention. They came to Jesus and said, Lazarus, your friend, was sick. Jesus said, the sickness was not unto death. He could see beyond what they were seeing. And there was a time in John 11, he said to them, our friend Lazarus is sleeping. He said, let's go to wake him up. Can you imagine? Somebody who had already died for about 4 days. But Jesus said the man was sleeping. It takes inside light to see outside light. And that is why the Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter number 5 verse 7, we walk by faith. In other words, we walk by revelation and not by what we see. You can be confused with what you see around, because what you see may not even correspond with the thing, covenant of glory. But with revelation, you can see well. This morning, you will see well.
Amen.
I can't hear your amen. You will see well.
Amen.
How far you see determine how fast you go in life. That's the truth. Where others are seeing confusion, you will see future.
Amen.
Are you here? Say, you will see future.
Amen.
You will see future.
Amen.
Where others are seeing death and sickness, you will see life.
Amen.
Your amen is too slow and small, you will see life.
Amen.
Where others are seeing and saying business breakdown, you will see business breakthrough.
Amen.
Where others are seeing confusion, you will see direction.
Amen.
And I hear a better amen.
Amen.
The difference between Esau and Jacob is your revelation. All what Esau could see was food, but Jacob could see the future by revelation. And what happened in Jeremiah chapter number 1 verse 11, when God asked him a question, and he said, and I said, it is one thing for you to see by revelation, it is another thing for you to say what you see. Jeremiah said, I saw, and he declared what he see. He declared it. So whatever you have seen about this month, you need to declare it. And that means that as you step out of this place this morning, your declaration is that this month is the month of my covenant glory.
Yes.
From time to time, it must be in your mouth. It's my covenant of glory. This month is my covenant of glory. You are driving. You have to declare whatever you have seen. Because whatever you don't declare, God is not permitted to deliver it to you. So you must be able to declare from time to time. And whatever you don't declare, you don't deserve. You have a future. You have a future. So you must declare it. Whatever you don't say, you can't see in life. It's a law. It's a principle. God said and God saw. God said in Genesis chapter number 1. God said, God saw. God said, God saw. God said, God saw. You have to declare whatever God has shown to you. You have to. One thing is to hear. Another thing is to see revelation. When whatever you see by revelation, you begin to declare it. Declaration. Declaration. Job chapter number 22 verse 20 says, thou shalt decree a thing and shall be established. The light shall shine upon thy ways. You are empowered by God to design your life by declaration of God's word. There was a sister that was sharing testimony at that time that she couldn't understand what was happening on the 1st of September. And please, we need to understand that we have the mandate from heaven. Once we step into a new month to begin to design and declare what you want that month to look like and what you want happen. Whatever you don't say, you don't see. So when you wake up on the first day of each month, you have that assignment to design and to define and to declare whatever you want it happen. No sickness, it will never step near you. No death, it will not happen. No confusion, it will not. And whatever you want it happen to you, you begin to declare it. If you don't say it, nothing happens. And whatever happens to you negatively, God is not to be held responsible. And that's the truth. So you must have that understanding. You must have that understanding. You must have that understanding. It takes inside light to speak outside light. I said something the other time that it takes inside light to see. But now it also takes inside light to speak outside light. There are a lot of things that if God is not taking you back, you can be influenced by the environment and begin to say what they are saying. But the inside light helps you to speak differently. 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 Number three, it is not enough to see revelation. It is not enough to say declaration. You must be expectant. Expectation. Expectation. Whatever you have declared, the covenant of glory. Glory is my portion in this month of October. So as you declare it, you also expect it. Proverbs chapter number 23 verse 18 says, for surely there is an end. Said, thy expectation shall not be cut off. Whatever you don't expect, you don't experience. And expectation is the foundation for manifestation. Expectation is one of the biblical keys to open the door of glory. You must be expectant. Lord, I'm expectant. As you have come this morning, what are your expectations? You don't just come to church without expectation. You are stepping into the month of October. You don't just step into the month without expectation. Lord, I'm expecting this in this month. I'm expecting power. I'm expecting prosperity. I'm expecting victory. You begin to declare. You begin to declare. Amen. How do you move now from the realm of expectation to the realm of manifestation? The declaration of praise. Let someone say the declaration of praise.
The declaration.
Can you shout it louder? The declaration of praise.
The declaration of praise.
And that is what we have come to do, to praise Him.
Hallelujah.
To praise Him. Between expectation and manifestation, what do I do? The declaration of praise. As you praise Him, the Bible says, the heart will yield its increase. This land will yield for you.
Amen.
I can't tell you, it will yield for you.
Amen.
It will yield for you.
Amen.
Sir, you know what God is saying? He said, as you praise me, I will place you.
Amen.
As you praise me this morning, I will place you. Now, can I say this? Permit me to say this 50-50. Because it's a covenant, an agreement between two people. And he said, I will not break that covenant. Because I'm going to give you glory. So if you praise me, I will place you. It's as simple as that. 50-50. Praise five letters. Place five letters. So let's do it that way. Not only that, if you praise me, I will give you space. And when I'm talking about space, I'm talking about grace. The name of a man is a prophecy of his future. This place is Grace Assembly. It's a prophecy. It's a prophecy. And as the way God moves a man, when you praise Him, from the realm of grace to great grace to manifold grace to exceeding grace to abundant grace to the God of the world. another dimension. But you must have the knowledge to praise him. And that's why he says, if you praise me, I will raise you.
Amen.
If you praise me, I will raise you.
Amen.
I will raise you. I'd like you to believe this just short exhortation this morning. Revelation, declaration, expectation, the declaration of what? Of praise. And lastly, manifestation, you see yourself in the world of glory. That will be your portion.
Amen.
I can't hear amen. That will be your portion.
Amen.
Forget about what you are going through. He said, praise me, I will bless you. Praise me, I will give you space. He said, praise me, I will raise you. It's my prayer this morning that at the end of this month you will have a testimony.
Yeah.
Are you here? You will have a testimony.
Yeah.
Stand to your feet and let us praise. Lord, we thank you.
You are wonderful. You are wonderful.
Jesus, mighty name, we give you the praise.
can you just stretch your hands towards the man of God? I say, God should reflect and share. Every virtue that has gone out of him, the Lord should replenish. Should replenish in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Lord, we seal every good prophecy concerning your son by the blood of Jesus. We are saying the good prophecies will come to pass in your lives. In the name of Jesus. I pray for your son. Your garment will always be white.
Amen.
When it's time to declare the counsel of God, heaven will give you utterance. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The doors of utterance will always be open for you.
Amen.
You'll be a kingdom ambassador.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It shall be well with you.
Amen.
It shall be well with your ministry.
Amen.
It shall be well with your family.
Amen.
It shall be well with your home.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. How many of us are ready to make declaration this morning? How many of us, even if you have been dismissed, he will do what? He will bless you. Amen. When Prince spoke to that man in the pit, he was placed on course for his destiny. That was Joseph. Amen.
Amen.
Come and let me tell your neighbor, praise. And God will bless you.
Amen.
Amen. So, while we prepare the children for their Thanksgiving, please, the ushers, let's bring in the children. I will first call these people that their birthday, your wedding anniversary is this month of October. Please, can we just come and give them all praise. Amen.
Amen.
This is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, I will rejoice.
Multiply the years ahead of them in peace,
amen.
In plenty,
amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As many that are saying, God, thank you for our union. Lord, I pray the sweet wine in that union will never cease.
Amen.
It will not go down.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every day in that home will be only one day.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
A woman like Delilah will not visit your home.
Amen.
In that name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
Blessed be your holy name.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
In heaven you are the Lord.
pray. What do? We want to pray. Close our eyes. Okay, let's close our eyes. The congregation will join them. Father, we thank you for your children.
Thank you, Lord.
Blessed King of Joy, we magnify you because you are God. Father, we thank you for your children because you have been watching over them. King of Glory, we thank you for the wonderful things you've been doing in your life. Father, we pray and we are asking that this month will continue to be a shining light in your life. King of Glory, anything that helps you exact on this month, Father, you will banish. Lord God Almighty, anybody, they will never be tamed. Whatever they lay their hands on, even when they are playing, Father, they will excel.
Amen.
King of Glory, if these ones get into anything that is contrary to your will, Father, you will not allow it to happen.
Amen.
If there's anyone that wants to use these ones that for anything also that is contrary to your will,
yes,
Father, you will not allow it to happen.
Amen.
Lord God Almighty, we are praying that these ones will be an ambassador in your kingdom.
Amen.
They will be terror to the devil.
Amen.
When they go to school, Father, they will excel in their studies.
Amen.
When they are in their house, they will shine and they will glorify your holy name.
Amen.
Their parents will be proud of them.
Amen.
Their peers will look up to them for direction.
Amen.
They will be leaders of tomorrow.
Amen.
Father, we are asking and we are praying that their life will continue in every area to glorify your holy name.
Amen.
Thank you, Heavenly Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
I am.
Lord, I pray because they have praised you this hour. in the academics, Father, you bless them.
Amen.
They will be generation influencers.
Amen.
They will be world changers.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, I pray that these ones will excel.
Amen.
They will not know failure.
Amen.
In the mighty name of
Amen.
Jesus. Father, wherever they stand, they will represent you well.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, like Joseph, Father, they will be deliverers of nations.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Glory be unto your name.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So you can drop your thanksgiving. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's time for general thanksgiving.
Amen.
Come on, help me tell your neighbor you cannot dance just in this place. Please help me tell that your neighbor.
Yes, you are the Lord most high. Your word says, let them praise his name in dance, and let them sing praises unto him with temperance and love. For the Lord shall take pleasure in his people, and shall beautify their life with salvation. The saints shall be joyful in glory, not because we have sung and we have danced. Lord, I pray, beautify our life with your salvation. Take us from one level of glory to another. In the name of Jesus. When the destiny of Joseph was buried, Judah spoke, which means praise. And that destiny was released and set on course. Lord, I pray, the praises that we have given unto you today, Lord, cause it to speak. Yeah. And as many people that their destiny is buried, Lord, I pray, bring out that destiny from pits. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. And set those destiny on course. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. You said, let the people praise me. And let the people praise thee, then the earth shall yield its increase. Lord, I pray, because we have pressed you this hour, Lord, cause the earth of Dubai to yield its increase unto us. Everywhere the foot of our leg shall tread upon, in this land of Dubai, Lord, it shall yield its increase unto us. All the good things that is meant for us in this land of Dubai, because we are here on a divine agenda, Lord, I pray, let the earth begin to yield its increase unto us. There is nobody that is here by accident. It is divinely planned. Lord, I pray, release our destiny in this land. Cause us to walk into divine purpose. Jesus, as many that have really praised you, there is a miracle in praise. Because your word said in the book of Isaiah, you said when we praise him and when we praise thee, there is going to be healing. Oh Lord, I pray, as many that has praised you, Lord, let healing be available unto them. In the name of Jesus, you are healing your body. You are healed in your soul. Amen. Emotionally, you are healed. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. As many that are depressed, as many that are worried, fear this breath today. Lord, let every Jericho walk for down. Amen. Every worry disappear. Amen. Emotional torture disappear. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. I speak over your life today. Go and begin to do exploits. Begin to do wonderful things. Go and begin to become a wonder to your world. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name we are praying. Lord, we bless this Thanksgiving offering. Let it be used for your glory. In the name of Jesus. As we have given unto you, Lord, give back unto us. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's have our seat for some comments. Amen. Amen. Some people may be wondering, what are these people doing? Amen. Praise can speak. And when it speaks, destinies are released. God said, I dwell in the praises of my people. There is no man that ever praise God that go down. Rather, they are always going up. If you need the presence of God, you need to go to the Praise FM and switch on that. Amen. Many of you that are shouting, God, where is your face? You don't need to ask for God's face. If you want to have God's face, God lives in number one prayer venue, Thanksgiving bus stop. If you need, you just go there. You get to a Thanksgiving bus stop, then you enter into that court. The challenges may be there. You say, God, I'm more interested. I just want to praise you for who you are. you forget all your sorrow, forget your emotion when you are in the presence of God. Yes. Hallelujah. So it is not something, go and check those people that get miracle, they get it mostly in praise.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. You just close, you switch off from men and you switch on to God. That's when you begin to praise God, that's when you switch on to God. And I pray that your testimony today will be permanent.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I was in a meeting and I asked them, I said, please everybody praise God this hour for 30 minutes. After the 30 minutes, it was a vigil. People begin to, you know, people just begin to rush out to come and give testimony. That my headache disappeared, fever disappeared, this event disappeared. So when I say come and praise God, don't sit down there. It is a time of miracle praise.
Amen.
Don't be like that man at Bethsaida. Said, I have no man. You don't need any man. You need only God. One with God is majority.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
You need to carry God. Carry God into the new month. Amen.
Amen.
I know that this praise will not stop here.
Amen.
It will continue. So next month, I want you to invite a friend for a Jericho praise. That is where walls, barriers, problems are giving way.
Amen.
You need to key into this. Earlier we are told, if you don't expect anything, there will never be any manifestation. If you don't praise God, God cannot place you. Even when you have been displaced, you will be God will place you back.
Amen.
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 I want you to invite a friend next month and say, God, and don't just invite people. You yourself, don't be an instructor, be a participator.
Yes,
sir.
Amen.
Saul wants to participate. You know, he just wants to see. But David participated and his throne was established forever.
Amen.
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 So another Jericho praise next month, invite somebody. Amen.
Amen.
There are some people worshiping with us today for the first time. If today's your first time, can I see your hand? Today's your first time. God bless you. God bless you. Can you just rise up on your feet and come to the seats too? And then my right hand side here. Please just rise up on your feet and follow the cautions. Assembly family. You came today as a visitor, but you are living as a member of the family. The ushers are giving you a guest card. Please just fill the information with capital letter and return it back to the ushers before you leave. Please, immediately after the service, don't be in haste. The pastorate and the welcome team would like to meet with you shortly after the service. God bless you. Let us pray. Righteous Father, thank you for bringing these ones unto yourself. Lord, as you have brought them, Lord, bless them.
Amen.
Lord, make today a memorable day in their life.
Amen.
Give them a testimony that will become a testament.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Amen.
Blessed be your holy name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So, I want to quickly say this. Where we have a form that has been given to everybody. Check your bulletin. It is called Church Data. When they wrote contact, please put your email address. And the pastorate would like to say hello to you on your birthday and wedding anniversary. So when you see wedding there, M and year, just give us the month and the year. DOB, that is date of birth, just give us the day and the month. We don't need the year there. Amen.
Amen.
Just tell us the day and the month. And please, if you have filled the ballot data, please return it back to the ushers before you leave. This one is for everybody. Amen.
Amen.
Don't say that they just announced people's wedding anniversary. What about me? They pray for people.
and some people receive SMS. Please fill the biodata and return it back to the ushers. God bless you. Amen. Shall we just rise up on our feet and give the Lord praise for what He has done today? Lord, we give you praise. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Can we take our family love song? I want you to hold somebody as you take the family love song. Lord, I pray our blessings via praises today will be lifetime blessings.
Amen.
Never to be reversed.
Amen.
Your word is irrevocable. No man can change your word because it's a law in heaven and on earth. That which you have done in our life today, let it be permanent.
Amen.
The enemy will not remove the garment of praise
Amen.
On our body,
Amen.
In our lives,
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As we go into the new week and the new month, Lord, go into the new week and the new month with us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Let's share the grace and fellowship. Surely, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want you to be nice to at least 10 neighbor as they move from glory to glory. And if this month is your
move from glory to glory.
Please, let's bring the cake for your celebrant. If this is your month, wedding anniversary, then please.
Amen.
Thank you.